In this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can use the Roto Brush, Generative Fill, and Content Aware Fill to make yourself disappear or create other effects with a moving camera. Generally, it's difficult to do things with a moving camera without tracking everything or having motion control. This way, you can do special effects with a moving camera without having to have everything locked off on a tripod. The first step is to bring your footage into After Effects. And then we're going to use the Roto Brush tool to separate the character from the background. Then we'll use Generative Fill to make some keyframes that will work for the Content Aware Fill in After Effects. Double-click on your source layer in the timeline. This brings it up as a layer. This is different than the composition view. You can only use the Roto Brush in the layer view. The Roto Brush tool is up in the top next to the eraser. You can press Control or Command and left mouse button to change the size of your Roto Brush. Make big strokes right in the middle of your character. This is better than going around the outline of the character, as this will teach Roto Brush what you want. Change the size of the brush and try to make as few and as simple strokes as possible. This will keep the calculations going faster. After you've instructed what the character is for Roto Brush, you need to tell it what the character is not. Hold Option or Alt to tell Roto Brush things that are the background. It will make red strokes, and these will be the background and not be cut out with the Roto Brush. Anytime you make a mistake, make sure you undo it rather than keep that information in the Roto Brush. Change the size of the brush for details. Look around, double check your Roto Brush. For this technique, it doesn't need to be perfect. We just need a general cut of the character. Roto Brush 3 does a really good job with a single frame. For more complex cuts and rotos, you may need to make multiple reference frames or correct your Roto Brush along the way. For this technique, I'm just going to let it do whatever it does from the first frame because I want the effect to be able to happen quickly without much effort. You can also use Refine Edge for the hair if that is important. Now that I have a good keyframe, I'm going to select Freeze on the Roto Brush. This will freeze all the frames. Roto Brush really does a good job of tracking the character in determining what is background and what is the character. For quick object cutouts out of footage, this is really one of the best ways to do it. Now that the Roto Brush is frozen, we have all these frames. We can close the layer, and now you'll see that the character is cut out on the background. But we've lost our background. In order to get the background back, we'll duplicate the layer, Command or Control C, and then Command or Control V. On the second layer, go to Effects and Controls and delete the Roto Brush effect. Now we have a layer with the Roto Brush and one without. We're going to use the Roto Brush layer as a track mat for the lower layer. If you don't see track mat right here, make sure you click the icon down in the lower left of your screen. And then on this lower layer, we can select the mat of Disappear Roto. So now this is tracking the mat from above, so it looks the same. This way we can invert the mat. Now we have a mat that is just cutting the character out. Let's label the layers to keep track. This is the figure, and we can still turn its visibility on if we need to see the figure. Now we're going to focus on the background. We need to create some reference frames so After Effects Content Aware Fill can fill in the rest. Go to Window, Content Aware Fill. The Content Aware Fill layer works on the alpha. We want to make sure that we expand the alpha a bit. That way, it doesn't matter if our Roto Brush was a little off. 10 to 15 pixels should be good. It's important to select the correct fill layer for Content Aware Fill. We're replacing an object, so select Object. We do want lighting correction, so it helps with any lighting changing. Then click Create Reference Frame. This will automatically open up the frame in Photoshop. Then use the magic wand to select the alpha. Since we didn't do a perfect roto, sometimes Generative Fill will see the outside pixels of your figure and try to create a new figure. This can have fun results, but it's not always what we want. Go to Select, Modify, Expand. Expand by 10 pixels or so. Then press Delete to delete those pixels. After that, click Generative Fill, Generate. Select the one you want. I think this first one is pretty good. I know this particular room does not have windows here, so I'm going to fill those in by selecting Generate. For complex situations, you can always pull in frames and information from other parts of the video, but for this demonstration, this is good enough. Once you're happy with that clean plate, save the Photoshop file. You can always come back in and edit this. Go back to After Effects. Then we're going to move forward a little bit and find another frame just to give plenty of information for the content aware fill. Create one more reference frame. Once again, select the magic wand tool, select modify, expand, expand by 10 pixels, delete the information, generative fill, generate. This has created a little puppy dog that's pretty fun. I'm going to go ahead and select the dog and remove it. Save the Photoshop file. Once we're back in After Effects, make sure you have the background layer selected, then select Generate Fill Layer. It will analyze the reference frames as well as the surrounding area and create a content-aware fill. This can take a little bit of time. Once it's done analyzing, then it will render PNG frames for all the missing information to fill in the video. Once After Effects is done generating the fill layer, you can scrub through and you'll see that you are missing your character. There's still some shadows and whatnot, but now we can do all kinds of different things with the character since it's on a different layer. First, we need to move the figure above the fill layers. Otherwise, if I click the eyeball, I don't see the figure. So I'll move the figure above those fill layers. Then if I click the figure, I can see the figure again. And now we can do things that just affect the figure. For example, I can duplicate this layer. That way it doesn't affect the track mat below. Hide the first one. If I scale the figure, I can scale the figure down and I still have background. So this is a pretty cool way to make the figure change size. Notice the anchor point is not where the figure is. Make sure you have that layer selected. Select the pan behind tool. Then you can move the anchor point to where the figure is. Now, if I select scale, the figure will scale into nothing. So I can have the figure running along, set a keyframe for scale by clicking the stopwatch, move a little bit further forward, then put 0 for scale. Now we have 2 keyframes, and this will show that the figure is running and then disappearing. We can do all kinds of different things to the figure. So if you go to effects and presets, you can change different parts of the figure. You can move things around. Generally, you can always use rotoscope to separate the figure and do things like add colorama to the figure, and it only affects the figure. But what's nice about having the content aware fill is besides using the colorama on the figure, we can use some of the generative or distortion effects because we still have background. For example, if we go to the distort menu and bring in something like CC slant, now we can set keyframes on CC slant. And as we slant the character over, the background is still there. And we get this great effect of having the character run back and forth and still have the background there. That's because we use content aware fill to have the character separated and then filled in the background. So we can create these effects that wouldn't have been available otherwise. Here you can still see the door. And it's kind of fun because we see the shadow of the character. So you can use this for all kinds of creative effects in your projects. We could also do CC Tyler. So you can make many of the characters. And you could, again, this could be keyframed. So we could have the scale keyframed here, have it 0 at the beginning, then move into here, and then have it come back to 100%. And again, we don't have to worry about the background because the background is already there. Another thing you can do is play with the opacity. So here, if T on figure 2, I can change the opacity down and have the figure be semi-invisible or fading in and out, which is kind of fun because we can see the background behind the person because it's not a perfect rotoscope, but again, it doesn't need to be because we have the full figure in the frame. Another fun distortion effect is CC Bend It. So if we put this here, we can bend the character back and forth, which is really fun. So you can change the start and end points. So if we have the start point be over here and the end point be over here, we have the whole character in the bend, and then you can change how much it bends. So you can have the character wandering around like this while the footage is moving. So let's go ahead and put a keyframe right here on bend, then move this way, then we'll increase the bend a lot. And remember that the start and end points are also animatable. So we can put 2 keyframes right here, move along, and then move these points as well. So you can create kind of interesting, trippy effects that seem like the character is definitely still part of the footage, yet is moving around with a background that is created by generative fill and content-aware fill. So this really opens up a lot of different possibilities that may or may not be possible unless you have a green screen and then perfectly tracked footage. Here you can quickly rotoscope a character out and then change it around to different things. Hopefully this helps you be more creative with your footage quickly with the rotoscope, generative fill, and content-aware fill.